Thank you very much, Alberto, for some political banalities. No, you're supposed to sit here. For several political banalities, but also for highlighting the difference between self-determination and independence, as well as this new kind of attachment between regional nationalism and Europe as a whole. The next speaker also comes from Barcelona, Rafael Arenas Garcia. Thank you for joining us. I know that you're under a tight schedule, so we'll do our best to make sure that you get on time to the airport following the discussion that we have. The floor is yours.
Thank you.
Well, good morning, Salom. Bon dia, buenos dias. Thank you very much for the invitation. I'm very happy to be here. It's also my first time in Israel, and I'm glad to be in this country that I feel so close to me.
And this colloquium was already a success if we managed to bring some of you for the first time to Israel.
Yeah. That's another success in this seminar. So, oh my God, where is the presentation? To start a presentation here. Next time, I'll do it in ever. So, thank you. To take part in this seminar that I find highly interesting, I think the debate could be intensive, and I'm going to deal now with some of the matters that we have heard in the previous presentations, just to go with my own presentation. The future of Catalonia. Well, we can start with some simple facts. This is Catalonia. This is the country, the land we are talking about. And Catalonia is a Spanish autonomous community. You have here the map of Spain. You see Catalonia there in the northeast part of Spain. So at this moment, and talking about the simple facts at this moment, Catalonia is an autonomous community in Spain. We can deal with the historical problems in the debate, but I'm just trying to explain what we are facing now. And is a region of the European Union. So we are a part of the European Union. You can see here the map of the European Union. You cannot see in this map the regions, but in each country there are regions that are recognized by the European Union. But this, to be a part of the European Union, is ever as a part of Spain. That is very important to understand what we are facing. The European Union is an international organization of states. And then, when a territory is a part of the European Union, it's because he's a part of the territory of the state. In this case, the territory of Spain. That is important because in the debate in Catalonia during the last 5 years, there was an argument, there was a strong opinion between some people saying that in the case of secession, Catalonia will continue being a part of the European Union as an independent state, and the Catalan people will continue to be European citizens. That is not true. I have here the remark by President of the European Council, German Van Rompuy, of the year 2013. It's a little bit small, but it's easy to find, that explains that in the case of secession of a part of a territory of a state, this part of the territory, this territory, is no longer part of the European Union. And this is Spain. Some simple facts about Spain. Before, Professor Castells explained that Catalans tried during the 19th and 20th century of modernizing Spain or get or convert Spain in a better country. So I think that they succeed because Spain now is a modern country, is an economical powerful country in the world between the 15 and the 20 economies in the world by the ground gross income product. I thought that it was not just only for the Catalans, that Spaniards coming from Catalonia, from Madrid, from Andalucía, from Galicia, worked together to build the modern Spain. But if some people want to think that it was Catalan people in Catalonia that created this marvelous country that is now Spain, well, there is no problem to admit that. So we have a modern economy, and what is more important for our purposes, Spain is a modern democratic country also. It's a consolidated democracy, the Constitution of 1978, and if we attend to international standards, we find that Spain is considered between the most democratic countries in the world. This is a study for Freedom in the World, the year 2017. Here is the ranking of the economies of democracies in the world. Well, Spain is the 16th. We would prefer to be the first, but at this moment is the 16th. I think that we must work to improve that. I think that in every country, and also in Spain, we have to be working every day to improve our democracy. This is very, very important, and I think that our purpose should be to become one of to be in the top 10 of this list, and the if it's possible, the one, the first of the second. But at this moment, is the 17th in this list of the Economist. For example, the United States is the 21, and Belgium is the 35 at this moment. To explain that Spain is a democratic country, taking into consideration international standards. And there is another information that I find interesting. This is my own creation, taking into consideration the web of the European Court of Justice. If you visit the web of the European Court of Justice for Human Rights, the Court of Strasbourg, not the Court of Luxembourg, the Court of Strasbourg, you find the number of judgments finding at least one violation of the European Court of Human Rights. And you have the number of judgments for each country. I have selected here 9 countries. France, Germany, Italy, United Kingdom, Spain, Netherlands, Belgium, Sweden. Then you see that Spain, that is this one, is one of the countries with less judgment of the European Court of Human Rights, finding a violation of the chart. This country here with almost 1,800 is Italy, and France, for example, has almost 800. So we, as I have said, we must work every day to improve our democracy. But it's completely unfair to say that Spain is not a democracy. And this is an argument, this is an idea that we have heard many, many times. The facts are this. Okay. To reach... And now we, in Catalonia, the problem is that we have a divided society. I have here two pictures. The pictures on the top is a demonstration, October the 8th. You see the Spanish flags is in Barcelona, hundreds of thousands of people demonstrating because they don't want the secession. The picture on the bottom is an independentist demonstration, October 28th in Barcelona. Many people, hundreds or thousands of people. And we in Barcelona are facing this situation since months we are seeing demonstrations sometimes at the same places with hundreds of thousands of people saying just the opposite. One people strongly in favor of independence and people strongly against independence. So we have to consider this as a base to any solution. We have a divided society. If we see the results of the regional elections, we can consider also the results of the general elections, but here you can see the result of the regional election in 2015, and then you see this is the votes. Then I have another picture with the representatives. But if you see the votes, this that is almost red is the Junts pel Sí, pro independence, and the second one, almost yellow, is CUP, a radical lefty independentist party that is also in favor of independence, and you see that it's almost the half. It's not just the half, it's almost the half. Then you see Ciudadans, Partit Socialista, Catalunya Sí que es Pot, and it's even, but you cannot see here, the Partit Popular. The other picture is more clear, then you have here the vote to independentist party and the rest of the vote. You see that the situation is that there is a strong position of the independents, but in a divided society. If you see, this is another picture, independentist vote over census. Of course, the pictures before were about the independentist vote over the votes, and this is over the census because the abstention in Spain in the last regional census it was more than 22%. So if you consider the whole census, the result is this. And here you have the regional parliament just before the dissolution, between 2015 and 2016. Then you see that there was almost half of the votes, it was in favor of independentist parties, but taking into consideration the electoral act in Spain, this almost half supposes more than half of the representatives at the parliament. No scandal about that, because this happens in all countries, that the situation with the representatives is not the same that with the votes, and this is legitimate. No, I don't discuss that. No, it's just to show what we are facing. Spain is a decentralized state. It was explained before. We have a central government, autonomous communities, municipalities with different competencies. The autonomous communities, well, all the autonomous communities don't have the same competencies. For example, education, health are for all the autonomous communities. But for example, in Catalonia, we have also a regional police that another autonomous communities don't have. I think that only Catalonia and the Basque Country have regional police. And Catalonia is the only autonomous community that have competencies in prisons. The prisons in Catalonia are depending of the regional government, not of the central government. So the situation in Spain is complex because we have three main levels, and there are sub-levels, but three main levels of government, and not all the autonomous communities have the same competency. So it's complicated but funny. And taking into consideration the autonomous communities, we have a legislative power, but the legislative power of the autonomous community is limited, is constricted to the competencies determined by the Constitution and the Estatuto de Autonomía, the basic law of the autonomous community. These two important norms, two important laws, the Constitution and the Estatuto de Autonomía, define the framework of the legislative power at the autonomous community. And what is happening now? That the regional government and the parliament in Catalonia started to act outside the framework they have. The 6th and 7th September, the regional parliament in Catalonia derogate the Spanish constitution and derogate the status of the autonomía without having a strong majority, just with the 72 deputies of the independentist parties. So this was very very serious for all of us, because we were saying on TV that our regional parliament, it was destroying itself. It was destroying itself because he denied to continue acting as a regional parliament, because in a conscious way he decided to act as a parliament of the new republic, in a challenge to the constitution, to the Estatuto de Autonomía, and to the constitutional court. And this challenge continued during the month of September. The first picture you see, this is Carles Puigdemont. Maybe you know all who Puigdemont is. And this here are the requirements of the Constitutional Court ordering him to stop his illegal action. And he showed in Twitter a picture with these requirements, saying to all the world that he will continue to act outside the law. There we can see another Twitter from Mr. Puigdemont explaining how the people, against the orders of the constitutional courts, against the orders of the High Court in Catalonia, could participate in the referendum the 1st of October. And then we have here two another pictures. This picture is 21st September. In the framework of a judicial investigation about the criminal offenses committed not for the government in relation with the 1st of October, but before this situation, a judicial commission composed by policemen and judicial officers came to one of the buildings of the Generalitat, and outside the people blockade this judicial commission, destroy the cars of the police, and made that the judicial commission must stay inside the building for 10 hours. And okay, and there's the other images of 1st October, in that the police with orders of the judge to take all the material used in the referendum was prevented to do that by the people at the schools where the referendum was being developed. We can talk after that about this situation, because I have just 5 minutes and I want to. Well, this is the first declaration of independence, because in Catalonia we have two declarations of independence, 10 October and 27 October. The challenge to the state ended with the Article 155. Before that, somebody demand to read this article. Here you have the Article 155, so you can read it and see that is an article that, in very exceptional situations, allow the Senate, the Spanish Senate, to authorize the government to adopt extraordinary measures in order to recover the normality in an autonomous community. The article can only apply when an autonomous community is acting outside the law or acting against the general interest of Spain. I have that there is no doubt that during September in October, the autonomous community was acting outside the law. So the article, I think, could apply. We can discuss that after in the debate. And then What is the future? This is the situation till now, and what is the future? Well, we have an institutional crisis. The crisis is that, as I have explained before, the regional government and the regional parliament decided not to be no longer part of the constitutional order. This implies that the autonomous community lost their two main bodies, the parliament and the government. So we have to resolve this institutional crisis. We need to have in Catalonia a regional parliament and a regional government that we don't have now, not because the 155 article, because on September the 6th and September the 7th, the regional parliament and the regional government decided to quit the constitution. And to resolve this institutional crisis, we need the election, the regional election, on 21st December. This is the way to resolve the institutional crisis. And I'm going to answer one of the questions made before. And if the result is a majority of independent parties, no problem. The problem is not to have a majority of independentist parties. The problem is acting outside the law. This is the problem. If there is a regional parliament acting inside the law, the institutional crisis will be resolved. And we have the political problem. And now I'm going to talk about the political problem. But the institutional problem is also very, very important, at least for us, that at this moment don't have a regional government and a parliament, and a regional parliament. There are problems in Catalonia that must be resolved. There are the democratic deficits in Catalonia. This is the first page of a study about these democratic failures in Catalonia. You can find this document in the web. For example, we have a problem of lack of neutrality of the institutions. This is a town hall with flags, independentist flags, at the town hall. So even in electoral periods, before the elections, we have at the town halls and other public spaces flags defending the independentist movement. This is against the law in Spain because it supposed that the administrations must be neutral. And we have also problems of lack of neutrality at the schools. There are these pictures at the schools. We can discuss that during the debate, but you can see that an independentist flag at a school that is not in accordance with the obligation of neutrality of the school and of the administrations. And then, which is the solution? Well, I think that, as I have said, we are a divided society. You have here the two pictures. And so we must talk. We must talk between Catalans. This is the first step, to recognize the other. The nationalist, the Catalans that are not nationalists must recognize that there is an important part of the society that is nationalist. But the nationalist side must also recognize that there is an important part of the society that is not nationalist. Before, I have heard Sociedad Civil Catalana is neither society, neither Catalan. What do you mean with neither Catalan? We are not Catalans? The hundreds of thousands of people that demonstrate in Barcelona. If this is the point, we are not going to find a solution. The solution is to recognize the other, to recognize that we have a problem between Catalans nationalists and Catalans not nationalists. This is the first step to resolve the situation. The rule of law. Very important. I'm finishing, sorry. The rule of law, very important. Why? Because as we are a divided society, there are no consensus here, the society, here, there in Catalonia, there are no consensus. And we have a society divided without consensus. The only thing that guarantees the peaceful, the peace is the rule of law. If one of the sides decides to act outside the law, which are the options for the other side? To submit to the people who is acting, who are acting outside the law, or to act also outside the law? In these situations, when there is a strong division of the society, the strict respect to the law is very, very, very important. And we can change the law, of course. We can build a Spain proud of our diversity and a constitutional reform. Why not? Why not? It's possible. In Spain, it's possible to change the constitution. It's possible to change. It's not mandatory to change the constitution. Everybody in Spain can introduce an issue on the public debate, but this doesn't mean that this issue should be accepted, must be accepted for the other people. You can introduce the discussion, but it will be the whole country who is going to decide if the constitution must be reformed or not must be reformed. But this reform of the constitution, key elements for me, the agreement between Catalans first. This is the first step to recognize the division in the Catalan society. Any agreement between the nationalist side in Madrid is going to be a failure because it's not recognizing the other part of the Catalan society. We have to analyze the developments of our democracy for the last 40 years. I mean, a strict analysis, a strict study of what we have made since 1978, and then to find what is better for all the Spaniards. And maybe it's better for all the Spaniards to recognize the right to self-determination to all the autonomous communities. Maybe, I don't think so. But if we introduce this debate, we can finish indeed. But in this situation. But at the end, all the Spaniards must decide what they want to do with their country. Thank you very much.